It's finally here. After however many years, it's finally here. I've been waiting for this game since it was announced. And as soon as Hiveswap Act 2. Import Act 1 save. Okay. Hey guys, Red Script here. Today we will be playing Hiveswap Act 2. Joey, are you doing okay? Yeah, give me a second. What do you think? It fits, at least. It sort of smells like nacho cheese, but it could be worse. Oh yeah, sorry if I grabbed a dirty one. Just make sure you keep your hood up. Do you think it will fool anybody if I don't have horns? Well, just keep your head down if you can. Sure, of course. I guess the next question is, where are we headed? You said we're going to see one of your friends. Will he freak out when he sees me? Critia? No, I don't think she'll really care about you being an alien. Besides, she's got way more important things to think about right now than with her huge party going on. Well, I'll keep my eyes peeled for a better disguise. How many people are going to be at this party? Probably a lot. She's a violet blood, so, you know. No, I don't know Zephyros. I don't know anything. Right, wow. Basically, all you need to know is she's pretty influential, and getting her on board was a really big break for us. But right now, we should probably just get out of here as fast as possible. What with the drones and all. Right. Sorry about your house and everything. And your crushed bones. Yeah, I'll be fine. Great! Need any help with your journey? The question mark button on your UI is available for use. Hints will now be accessible at all puzzling points of the story when Joey is the active character. Huh? Who said that? Said what? I must have been hearing things. Let's go find some train tickets. Oh my god! It's been so long! Look. He seems a little stressed out. Closer look and you're pretty sure you know why. Yeah, that would suck. You gonna pass out? No. Good, because I'm not catching you. Stop scratching at your wound. What would your Lucis say?
He wouldn't say anything. He's dead.
Ugh, it's a hypothetical scenario. Mine's dead too, Nook Breath. Oh. Oh my god, are you guys okay?
Wow, I'm being an idiot. Of course you aren't okay.
It's fine. Sometimes you just lose stuff. Sometimes a leg. Sometimes you lose the person who raised you from a grub. That's life.
Wow.
Should I just completely good luck, I guess. Good luck, I guess? You too. Okay. I hope everything works out okay. Oh yeah, same. Dang it! No, I can't ask. I am a fool. Look. You don't think you have any money, and you don't know what they eat here. There was a lot of stuff in Domic's hive that what looks like it might have been food, but you kind of hope it wasn't. Yeah, troll food is really weird, apparently. I haven't played the original game in a while, and I haven't read Homestuck in... probably since it ended, so 4 years, so yeah. I'm just like, I can't remember anything. Okay, let's go in. Yeah, same. Oh, heck. Well, dang! There goes their escape route. Where are we? Last thing I remember is... the explosion. I thought I was dead for sure. Toothy must have dragged us to safety. Wow, Toothy, I never thought you'd do something like extract me from one of the silly situations I'm always getting into. I guess it's because Domic wasn't here to tell you any better. Ooh, what about all those trolls back there? Are they okay? Should we try to help them? No, I'm sure they're fine. Trolls are tough. Like, hey, even I'm still alive, right? Well, if you're sure. But what about your Lucence? Wasn't he right behind us? Just a drone bombing. No big deal. I'm sure he'll find his way home to wait for me. We should keep moving forward, right? But where do we go from here? Oh, I don't know. I've never been this far from Outglut before. I've never been this far from my planet. Wow, neither of us know anything. Hey, that's not totally true. We might both know only a few things, but maybe if we put our heads together, we'll know just enough. It'll all work out. Joey, you optimist. Actually, Joey, I don't think so. To get out of here, we'd need to know where we were and where we're going. The only way we could figure either of those things out is if we had a map, or if we used the constellations to guide us. Which neither of us could do anyway, because you're an alien and I'm stupid. Zephros, my child! Well, we'll probably be lost forever. So I think what you just said was an example of how being able to put words in whatever order you want doesn't make what you said necessarily true. But it did sound really, really cool. You know, why don't we take a look around before giving up? I guess that's a good idea, too. See what I mean? I'm too dumb to come up with plans like that by myself. Honey, no. Hello? There's no answer. Maybe it's abandoned? Hello? Is anyone here? Guess not. What should we do? Zephros? Ah! What is it? I'm sorry, it's just what? Even with the hoodie on, I can't stop freaking about how you don't have horns. Joey, we can't get onto the train like this. Everyone will know. Okay, don't panic. Why don't we take a look around? Maybe we'll find something. In someone else's hive? I don't know, that could end badly for us. You're right. Stealing is pretty rude, but it's an emergency. What if we left something in exchange? Well, I guess that'd be fine. As long as we do it in a way so that they can never track us down. Right. I wonder how much money I have. Wait. Obviously, I don't have any money. I'm on another planet. I don't even know what you guys use for money. Money doesn't really mean all that much in Alternia, but items of personal value are worth a lot. Like mementos and stuff? Yeah, kind of. Let's see what I've got on me. I have a Q-bat. No, I might need that. A bat. Are we expecting to play any sports? Only if we're unlucky. There's this mic Domic gave me. No, that's probably crucial to future events. The spoon I bent might work. Why were you carrying around a bent spoon? Makes me feel some small semblance of confidence, I guess. Zephyros, please don't attach yourself worth to it. In fact, you can bend a spoon. Okay, anyway, I'll just leave this right here. Now let's go find you a better disguise. Where's the spoon? Where's the spoon? There's almost enough junk here to build a scuttlebug. What's a scuttlebug? It's a primitive four-wheeled vehicular device that was exported from one of the Empress colonies 100 years ago. A scuttlebug can only be used on a wide, flat plane, so it never caught on because its users just ride your Lucis or take the train. But some trolls make them for fun because they're a good place to... Zephyros, why? But some trolls make them for fun because they're a good place to pale with your mate sprit. To what? With your what? Never mind! Let's just abruptly change the topic to anything else. Yeah. Okay. Hey, Joey, look at this cool stick. That is a pretty cool stick. I told you! You can't find a troll costume in this pile of junk. Aggressive clicking intensifies. No, we can't leave without checking everywhere first. Okay. Oh, there's something. It's still wet. You don't do much painting. Not really. Not really since all those watercolors in elementary school. Your mom used to put them up on the fridge. You don't know where they went. Oof. You'd imagine that since we're looking for something completely undefined and random, this would be the place to find it, huh? Yeah, kind of weird that it's of no significance to our journey at all. Bruh. You can't find a troll costume in this pile of junk. Quiet screaming. Okay, are we done? Oh, that's something. The person who lives here must be an artist. I wonder what this is supposed to mean. Too bad they're not here to tell us. I've heard the point of art like this is to interpret it ourselves. What do you think it means? I have no idea. I guess it could represent finding joy in the pure randomness of life. Oh, that sounds nice. But what if it means the exact opposite thing? The closer a Lobi like me gets to Ascension Day, the more they fantasize about randomness. This could be an expression of the artist longing to break free from the constraints of the caste system. Of course, any troll caught making art like this would be called for sedition in no time. But they couldn't keep pretending that they were loyally resigned to a brutal life of servitude anymore, and this is their last defiant act of freedom. Oh. That would be really sad if it was true, wouldn't it? But it must be nice to expire for something you believe in instead of living a long, pointless life. Knowing that you had a choice between safety and bravery and you chose the uncomfortable path. Which would you choose, Joey?
I don't think I've ever had to think about it before.
Oh, sorry, sometimes I just speak without thinking. I must sound pretty dumb right now, rambling like that. No, Zephyros, it's not a dumb question. Even if we never have to think about the difficult topics, it's probably a good thing to do. Otherwise, we don't even realize we're choosing, right?
Right.
So what are we doing right now? Is this safety or bravery?
Wow, this is starting to make my head hurt.
Me too. I'm not even sure what I know what it means to be brave.
Well, I think when you're a low blood like me, most of your choices aren't really a choice at all. They're simply the only possible option in any given scenario. So to be brave and leave a legacy, you have to make a difficult choice.
But what is a difficult choice? How do you recognize a real choice when you see one?
I guess it would be a choice that wasn't obvious at the time.
This is getting really, really deep.
Like dying in the violent blaze of glory for the right to make ugly art.
Or maybe it's just a monster with a bunch of feet.
Yeah, that's probably it. This artist may think about all that from just from looking at an unfinished piece.
They must be a genius.
I kind of think the important thing about art is what the person looking at comes up with themselves, not what the artist thought.
So that was all you, Zephyros.
I haven't checked here.
It's so realistic. Is it a statue or taxidermy?
Taxidermy?
Geez, how do I even explain this? Is it complicated?
Not really. I just hate it.
It's when you kill an animal, take out all its insides, and stuff the corpse with fabric.
Then you display it in your house in a sick display of dominance over nature.
Ooh, you mean like... taxidermitation.
I was like, what word is that?
Taxidermitation?
Taxidermitation.
It's when an imperial soldier gets demerited so hard that they forfeit the right to dignity and death. Oof. After they're executed, the Empress has their chitin stuffed and placed in her personal trophy room.
See, it can always get worse.
If you say so.
I'll probably come alive and bite you.
These mushrooms are huge.
Your planet has mushrooms?
Of course. When I was little, my dad taught me how to tell poisonous plants from edible ones in case I ever got lost in the wilderness.
I don't know what that just said.
Yeah, but I saw him get sick from something he ate on an adventure so many times that I'm pretty sure he just made it all up.
That's probably why I decided to stop trusting anything he says.
The one thing he's supposed to be good at is trekking through the savage underbrush, and he couldn't even teach me which mushrooms are okay to eat.
Well, not these ones. Vile glow mushrooms are the most poisonous fungus in Alternia. If you eat one, it will rot your stomach. When you touch them, they leave a residue that makes you burn up under moonlight like the sun is still out.
Oh no! But there's another mushroom called the noble glow that looks almost exactly the same except that the gills have a cell fold that grows in the opposite direction. The only way you can tell the difference is by lying flat on your back beneath the mushrooms and checking your global coordinates to make sure you've got the right one.
Couldn't you just touch it to see if it burns?
You're right. I'll do that right away. Zephyros, no! I was kidding! I like how he walked over to the mushrooms like, okay, let's try it out. And it's like, no! Okay, can I go now? Where haven't I checked? Okay, let's go back outside. Oh. Wait, I think I see something. Ta-da! They look just like horns. Wow, they really do. Finally! My goodness. Yay! I can go! Whee! I was not poking anything. Oh wow, I didn't know the cave would open up to such a cozy little farm. This place is adorable. Maybe your planet has some good things in it after all. Yeah, we should be pretty close to the next station. If we can get through the forest up ahead. Long distance local train stops have been regulated for 6 centuries to be spaced exactly 8 capacitors apart from one another, which means we're coming up on it. Zephyros, I have no idea what that unit of measurement could possibly equate to. Anyway, is this some kind of bee farm? The beehives are so cute. But where are the bees? Let's just keep walking. We don't want to get involved with anyone's private hive life. Aw, okay. But I want to see everything. Wait, don't look in the well. Huh? Why? It's filled with mind honey runoff. Mind honey runoff? It's pretty dangerous. It'll burn your view globes out of your head holes if you look at it. Oh gosh, thanks for warning me, Zephyros. I could have made a really big mistake. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, totally. You haven't seen a stage since your last dance recital in junior high, the one that ended in flames. Literal flames. You don't like to talk about it. Well, now I want to know! Luke. Where are the bees? Poke. Okay, you're not allergic, but you aren't going to poke beehives. But I want to poke the beehive. What a cute house, but the door's locked. Well, at least I didn't just hit go in right away. You actually cannot even begin to guess what the heck that is. It smells sweet and a little bit rotten. That's the right direction, so that's definitely where you need to go. Those woods are pretty dark, though. Joey, wait! Huh? What's wrong now? Don't tell me. Man-eating plants? Giant moths that fire lasers out of their butts? Trees that have big angry faces on them and use their branches to attack poor defenseless travelers like that one part in Snow White? Actually, yeah. You nailed it. Wow, Joey, you're so smart. You can't be serious. Not only do you have this crazy air, some kind of space throne trying to kill everyone. Your trees are also trying to kill everybody? Yeah. It builds character. Jeez, this planet sucks. So how do we get through this forest? Well, when Tetragnomic had me pass through the strange areas as a test of the flame of my inner strength, he rubbed me down with tusked vertebrae slurry so I could blend in with the local fauna. What is that? Tusked what? Oh, well, honestly, it's better if you don't know. Anyways, basically, applying any critter waste to ourselves from the local area will work. Crushed up bee carcasses, sac fluid, that sort of thing. We have to smell like the forest. Yuck. This is such a gross detour. Yeah, sorry you have to deal with it. Well, let's take a look around for some stuff to rub on ourselves so we can pass through the forest without getting eaten by giant trees or bugs or whatever. Back to the beehives. Poke. Dang it. go in. It's locked. We could just break in. What? Zephyros, it's a crime! It's fine. The owner probably won't be coming back anytime soon. That doesn't make it okay. It's not like we're going to steal anything. We're just going to look for something to help us get through the forest. Take what we need and get out. Like what we did in the caves. But how are we going to get inside without breaking anything? I don't want to ruin someone's nice home. I can just jostle the lock with my mind. It's a primitive tech lock hinge, so even my terrible psychics can do it. Wait. Your what? My psychics? Zephyros, hold on. Do you have psychic powers? Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's amazing! Why didn't you tell me? Do humans not have those? No? Wait, does everyone on this planet have psychic powers? No, not everyone. I think they're kind of uncommon, actually. But Burgundies tend to be more receptive to the mind stuff, so you can find a lot of gutter blood trash and weak sauce with weak sauce telekinetics. What? Including me. It's still really cool. No, it's not. Troll telekinetics are who are actually cool can fire. Words. Troll telekinetics who are actually cool can fire mind beams and command ghost armies and stuff, but usually the Jade Bloods call or indoctrinate the good ones before they pupate. I'm just one of the bad ones they left behind. Well, Zephyros is somebody who lives on a planet where psychic powers are only in Star Wars and horror movies and stuff. I think you're the bee's actual knees. Wow! I want to see you open the lock with your cool Jedi mind powers. Okay, sure. Just switch characters to me and use my telekinesis powers on the door. Okay, well, I know that this was probably, like, a fairly short episode for our first episode, and I know that I'm super excited about the game, but I'm gonna end it right here, because if I keep going, I'm gonna keep going for another, like, 15,000 hours, and I don't think anybody wants that. So, yeah, just gonna save this game. Oh my goodness. Just gonna save that boy. And I'll see you guys later. Bye.